Hello Libra and welcome to Coleman Tarot. My name is H.E. Coleman and this is going to be your reading for the month of August. Here we go. Okay, make sure you can see everything. All right, Libra, shuffle one more time just to make sure that we have a reading that's different from everybody else's. It's weird because no matter how much I shuffle, sometimes the same cards just show up all month long. Like it's the same for everybody. And I just wonder, how does that happen when I shuffle it so much? Okay. This one. Okay. You have the Six of Cups in reverse. You have the Eight of Swords in reverse. You have the Five of Cups. You have the Wheel of Fortune. You have the Hermit. You have the Four of Swords, you have your obstacle is the Queen of Wands, and your outcome is the Two of Swords in reverse. Great, okay. So this is the Six of Cups. This is your first card. And the Six of Cups is about nostalgia, thinking about the past, reconnecting with people from the past, and also letting go of things from the past, okay? And that is in reverse. So for some of you, this is about not letting go of the past. And that can be a good thing or a bad thing, because if you have something from the past that hurts you, you want to, it's really far away. If you have something from the past that hurts you, you want to let go of it because there's no reason to carry around all that hurt. But if you have something from the past that is unresolved, if you have a person from the past that you really want to keep, that has been drifting away from you, this is a great time to reconnect with somebody from the past. This is a great time to think about your childhood, and this is a great time to focus on things that you might have missed out on when you were a kid. And it's upside down. Okay, so this is definitely for a lot of you about letting go. This is definitely about not seeing things from the past as far as like your relationship used to be a certain way. Now it's a different way. And you can't sit there and say, oh, I wish that things were how they used to be. It's time to, you know, always be developing, always be changing, always be growing. Okay, you can't just hang on to the past and think, okay, well, why didn't I become a rocket scientist? Or why didn't I, you know, why didn't I do this? Or why didn't I do that? Or why is this person still hurting me even though I haven't talked to them in 10 years? Why do I still carry around this hurt? Okay. Over here you have the Eight of Swords in reverse. Okay. The Eight of Swords. And this is about fear. This is about being trapped by fear and being trapped by old wounds as well, because the swords are about experiences that are painful, and they're also about intelligence, and they are also about taking action. So this is about this person who's trapped in there, and she could easily just like walk around these swords, but she doesn't know that because she's so afraid that she's, you know, just trapped there by her own emotions. And this is in reverse. So this is about you getting over something that's hurt you in the past, getting over a feeling from the past, like you low self-esteem from when you were a kid and somebody said that they thought you weren't smart or something, and you carry that around with you. This is about moving past how you felt when you were a kid to realizing how different you feel and you could feel if you wanted to now that you're an adult, because you also have the Five of Cups. And this is about, there's three cups that are spilled and there's two cups that are still there. But this person isn't looking at the cups that are there. She's focused on the stuff that's spilt. She's focused on the stuff that she can't get back because it's gone. Okay? So it's time, this whole thing, this whole three first cards are about moving forward. Because if you just keep looking at the stuff that's gone or the stuff that's past, you're never going to move forward. You're just always going to be trapped. You're just going to be stuck there staring at these cups. Okay? You have to focus on these two cups that you still have and see what other cups are out there. I mean, if she leaves here, she could find new experiences that are not painful. She could find new cups that are not spilt, okay? You could find new friends and new partners and new people in your family that are not going to hurt you, okay? Now, and also if someone in your family is trapping you in fear, it's time to get away from that person. It's time to get to live a life that is not based on fear, okay? If you're feeling trapped with someone or you're feeling like you're hoping that that person's going to go back to treating you the way that they did before. It's relationships, as I said, are always evolving, and they usually don't go back to how they were before. So it's usually, you know, you're always moving forward and going into new phases of your relationship. So if you're fearful in a relationship, and you're feeling trapped and you're feeling worried, and the person's hurt you in the past and you're worried they're going to hurt you again, the thing is, in situations like that, usually never gets better, usually always gets worse. So you need to, this, all three of these cards are about moving forward and letting go of things that hurt you, okay? The Wheel of Fortune is in the middle of your month. This is about things changing. So since the first of your month is about being trapped in fear and looking at the past, and then you have the fear in reverse, which is about getting over that fear, the Wheel of Fortune is about change. And since it's the middle of your month and the first of your month is not so great, feeling trapped and feeling like, why can't things be how they were? Now the Wheel of Fortune is going to be changing. So now it's about looking forward, okay? Looking forward and getting stuff that's better than what you had or better than your expectations. Sometimes you want something and it doesn't work out and you say, why didn't it work out? And then you end up getting something that's way better than what you originally wanted, okay? Sometimes things don't work out for a reason, especially first relationships. You think of your first boyfriend or girlfriend and you think, why didn't this work out? But then you find out later that they're totally wrong for you and there's somebody else out there that's better for you, but you just can't see that at the time because you're a teenager. All right, here we have the Hermit, and the Hermit is about figuring out what you really want out of life. It's about going off by yourself and really thinking, what goals do I have for the future? What people do I want in my future? What house do I want in my future? What, you know, what do I want to do in the future? Who do I want to be in the future? What do I want to do? That's what the Hermit is about. It's about going off and doing some research and figuring out, like, what do I want for the future? Okay? So it's spending time by yourself. And look, you also have this one here. This is about meditation. This is about going off by yourself and looking at the big picture of life. This is about thinking about what's really important. Because the people who were going off to war, they used to go to the family crypt and say, you know, I could die tomorrow in the war, so what are really, who's really important and what's really important? So this is about meditation these days. Now it's about just laying there and thinking, what is the big picture? What do I really want out of life? Okay, both of these cards are very much about the same thing. Thinking about what's really important. Okay, now your obstacle is the Queen of Wands. And I'm not surprised at all. This is about confidence, not having enough confidence, not having enough self-worth, because you have the fear and then you have this over here where you're, you know, thinking about the past, and you have this where you're thinking about the past. So this is really about a low self-esteem, having not having enough confidence to break free from fear. And it doesn't even have to be a relationship. It can also be like you want something, but you're afraid it's not going to work out. You want to ask somebody out, but you're afraid they're going to say no because other people have said no. Or you want to take this job, but you're afraid it won't work out because what's going to happen if it doesn't work out? That's all fear, and you need to overcome that. You need to overcome the self-confidence. You need to tell yourself, hey, whatever comes, I'll be able to handle it. I'll be great. Because right now your obstacle is not having enough confidence. That's about overcoming self-doubt, overcoming the fact that you think you might not be able to accomplish something. And you can. You can. Okay, you're gonna, you have these cards here, meditation and thinking about the future and planning things out. These are usually followed by massive progress. Okay, these are about really thinking things through, really focusing on what you want. And when you do that, usually people always shoot forward in the relationship, shoot forward in progress with jobs, and shoot forward spiritually and say, okay, now I know what I want to do with my life. Now I know what I want my career to be. Now I know who I want to spend my time with. So whenever you do those kind of things, usually things really progress fast. So you don't need to be having a lack of confidence. And you can tell because here's your outcome. I didn't even think about this. This is your outcome. The Two of Swords in reverse. Okay. When it's like this, it's about a stalemate. It's about not going forward. It's about having no progress because the swords are there and she wants to use them. She wants to take action, but she can't because she's blindfolded. Does that sound familiar? Okay, so this is about not being able to take action. And in this one, it's because of fear. And in this one, it's because you just can't. You just, like, this is not the time to take action. Both of these are in reverse. Okay, so this is about getting over fear. You will be able to get over your fear. This is about not being blindfolded anymore. The blindfold comes off. You know exactly what to do. You feel like, okay, now I can take action. It's going to be, this is not being able to take action and being in limbo. This is, now is the time to take action. Now is the time to do something. Now is the time to try something that you're afraid of. Try something you're afraid of. Try something that makes you worried of, maybe it won't work out. What if something doesn't work out? You try again, or you try something else. Okay, so we didn't come here to be perfect. We came here to make mistakes and fall on our face and learn things. That's how you learn to walk. A baby takes a few steps and falls on their face, and they don't say, "Well, I can't do it." That's it. they get up and they walk again, they fall again, they get up and they walk again, they fall again. Same thing with skating. You skate, you fall, you get up. Okay. So if you try something and it doesn't work out, you don't need to be so much afraid of that. Don't be afraid of failing or falling or having somebody say they don't want to go out with you, because then you just ask somebody else, you know, like you just have to keep trying in life. Okay. So this is about you taking actions. This is about you no longer being blindfolded. You can see the truth. You can see what you want. You know what you want. You start to go after it. You start to take action. Okay. This is you taking off your blindfold, and this is you taking off your blindfold. Okay. Cause it's upside down. And this is going to be you focusing on what you have and what you want rather than what didn't work out in the past. Okay, here are things that are hidden from you. You have the Emperor, which is the universe giving you stuff that you want, which usually always happens after stuff like this. You figure out what you really want, figure out who you really want and what you really want out of life, and then the universe starts giving you stuff. Okay, that's about the universe giving you stuff. This is the Ace of Wands. This is about a brilliant new idea or a new project or a new passion. This can even be a new relationship. This is about something new that you're really excited about, okay? And that can also be from figuring out what you want. You say, okay, I want to suddenly go on a trip to Europe. And then you say, okay, I'm really excited about this. I'm going to start planning this, okay? Figure out what you want and go after it. The last one you have is the High Priestess. Good. This is about knowing things, being able to figure things out, being able to see what's going on around you. Okay. The High Priestess is almost like a psychic. They can tell if somebody's lying to them. They can tell if there's an opportunity around, they can see it. If something's wrong in their life, they can see it. If they're looking for the right person and they say, okay, that's going to be the person for me because that person has these qualities. It's almost like being a psychic. You're going to be able to see everything that's going on around you without, it's the opposite of the blindfold. Okay, here is your fate card. You get two. One is darkness looms on the horizon. This is just about you figuring out what you want. This is also about you saying, okay, I am accepting the fact that these three cups are gone. I need to move on. I need to find something that's going to be good for me. The darkness looming is just about realizing something's not right in your life and taking action. Then you have seduction. This is about passion and romance await. Passion and romance. And that can also be like this one right here. A new relationship, a new idea, a new spark. Passion and excitement awaits. Passion and romance await. Okay. Here is your spiritual card. And you got the Raven again. It's the same one. I'm going to give you two. All right. Dang, you know what? These cards are really a pain. Okay. Okay. You got the Raven, which is exactly the same card. And you got the High Priestess, which is exactly the same card. So this is about you seeing something that you can see it coming before it even happens. You can see something negative is coming. You can see something's coming that you don't like, and you take action before it gets bad. So if you're in a relationship that's abusive, you know that things are not going to be good, and you know that it's time to leave. If you have a job situation where you say, I realize I'm not happy in this job, and then you can go and look for another job, okay? And you're going to be able to find a lot of good opportunities when you have this one and this one here, the High Priestess, okay? So it's about you figuring out what you want, you figuring out what's not working, you seeing something coming that could be a danger, and then going and averting that with your new High Priestess abilities. Okay, so that is going to be your month, and I hope you have a great one. Your outcome is the Two of Swords in reverse, which is about you taking off that blindfold, getting over that fear that you won't be able to accomplish something, because even if you try something and you fail, who cares? At least you tried. It's better to try and fail than to never try at all. Okay. And then you have the meditation, which is about you figuring out exactly what you want. Okay. So have a great month. Don't forget that you also have the new romance, some kind of exciting passion, and something that you're going to be really, really excited about. Okay. Have a great month.